everyone, this is Funny. You are watching Funny HS Info. Today I am going to talk about reactor safety. What is a chemical reactor? It is an equipment used to carry on a chemical reaction, or a chemical reactor is an enclosed volume in which a chemical reaction takes place. Chemical reactors operate at high pressure and temperatures so that special considerations must be given to their safety during both planning and operating stages. Types of chemical reactors. There are different types of chemical reactors used in industries based on process and based on material of construction. Based on process, there are three types of reactors: batch reactors, continuous stir tank reactors, and plug flow reactors. Batch reactors used for solvent preparation, chemical mixing, chemical reactions, distillation, polymerization, and crystallization. Continuous stir tank reactors used for mixing of chemicals, generally used for waste water treatment. Plug flow reactors, in which chemical mixing in one end and collect at other end. Based on material of construction, depends on the chemical compatibility, there are different types of reactors are using. Some of the reactors are SS reactors for base chemicals, gas line reactors for acids, MS reactors for handling residues and recoveries, Haskeller reactors for both acids and bases, hydrogenation reactor for hydrogenation which withstand high pressure, and limpet reactors for heating or cooling through limpet coils. Next one, parts of reactor. A reactor is basically consists of a reaction vessel, feeding lines, agitator, jacket, motor gearbox coupling, brackets, and safety devices. Let us see some important parts of reactors and their functions. Safety relief valve or pressure relief valve and rupture disc for pressure controlling in case of high pressure buildup inside reactors due to chemical reactions. Rupture disc is set at maximum pressure of 1.5 times of a reactor, and there are different types of rupture disc like SS, Teflon coated, graphite, and cast alloy. Agitators are used for improve heat and mass transfers. There are different types of agitators: impellers, propellers, paddle, turbines. Propellers are used in low viscous to medium viscous liquids and low solid concentration slurries. Paddles are used to handle high viscous liquids and slurries. Turbines are best for gas liquid reactions due to radial flow patterns. Inlet outlet valves for feeding solvents and steam. Jacket or coil for handling reaction temperature, heating, cooling, and chilling is provided. Thermal relief valve for temperature control. Seal oil pot for mechanical friction protection. J dip or full dip for sampling purpose. Earthing sheet for earthing purpose. Next one, hazards related to reactor handling. Slip trip on the level on floor made wet or slippery as a result of leaks or spilling of chemicals. Fall from height during maintaining work in chemical reactors, piping, or from ladder. Electrocution from defective portable electrical equipment or due to work with defective electrical installations. Burns caused by contact with hot surfaces, hot water, or suddenly released steam, or freeze burns. Fires during work with flammable substances and or due to release of flammable gases during chemical reactions. Explosions from uncontrolled chemical reactions due to overpressure or heat release from exothermic reactions as a result of mechanical damage or corrosion. Exposure to hazardous substances due to sudden release of toxic materials from a reactor, whether the accidental or become human error. Acute poisoning and or chemical burns from extensive use of solvents, acids, bases, and other corrosive chemicals. Exposure to high levels of noise, especially during grinding, milling, crushing, and mixing operations. Exposure to chemicals which may cause different allergic reactions, respiratory tract irritations, asthma, eye irritations, and skin irritations or skin rashes. Musculoskeletal injuries related to awkward working postures during inspections and or maintenance works. These are the hazards related to reactor handling. Then what are the safety controls? Before handling a reactor, follow these instructions. Responsible supervision and chemist must be present at reactor handling area. Check the reactors undergo preventive maintenance and inspections as per schedule. Check the vessel lamp is working or not. The reactor should be checked for cleanliness. The reactor should be checked for proper earthing. Percentage of oxygen in the reactor before chemical reaction should be verified. The reactor should be filled with sufficient nitrogen. Ensure that the safety valve and pressure reducing station of steam line containing the reactor jacket are working properly. Check the reactor vent is connected to scrubber. Check the reactor temperature and pressure gauges are working properly. Safety instructions while handling a reactor. Check and confirm supply of required utilities by checking utility header pressure gauge or with utility operator. Ensure that the reactor should not run beyond the working pressure. Visually check the agitator rotation is in clockwise direction. The agitator should be stopped when the manhole cover needs to be opened. Apply chemical safety rules when handling or working with hazardous chemicals. Read MSDS and consult a safety supervisor regarding specific chemicals. The reactor should not be subjected to high temperature at once. Slow should be maintained by raising temperature. Chemical should be charged more carefully depending on the concentration of the chemical reaction. After completion of operation, switch off the agitator. Use good ladder to reach height levels. Make sure that the ladder is in required position with no possibilities of displacement or collapse. Learn and use safe lifting and moving techniques for heavy awkward loads. Always use required PPE like suitable protective clothing, safety helmet, safety goggles, safety shoes with non-skid and chemical resistant soles, respiratory protection and required hand gloves based on the chemical compatibility.